Alright, this plant here is called common wood sorrel. There's also a violet wood sorrel. The flower is purple instead of yellow. Common has the yellow. They have the five petals. But the biggest, easiest way to recognize it is by the leaves. This is also called a shamrock, which you ought to recognize it. But it has heart-shaped leaves, you know, trilobed, and has three heart-shaped lobes that attach at the leaf stalk. Now you can use the leaves in your salad. They taste all right. You can use the flowers. But the best part on a wood sorrel is the seed pods. You have right here, there's like five of them. Now there's some more right there. There's a bunch right there. The leaves are kind of bland. The flowers are kind of bland. But the seed pods right here are actually quite good. They have a little bitter lemony flavor. And they're not real tart, but they taste real good. You can spice up your salad a little bit. Myself, I kind of like them. They are high in vitamin C. Now, when you find one, which like this, and they're kind of a short plant, you'll tend to find quite a few. You got some there, some there, some there. There's a bunch back over here. But when you find them, you don't want to pick all of them. You want to, there's another seed pod. Pick what you need for the meal and then leave the rest for later. That way they can reproduce. And you can come back and get some more later. It's just like if you're picking the seed pods to throw in there to add a little tartness to your salad. Don't take them all, because if you take all the seed pods, there's no seeds left to reproduce. Now, it's such a low-growing plant that most people will walk right by it and not realize it, which is what I almost did. But since I found the first batch, they've been quite easy to spot, because I look for similar plants in the area, and then when I see those, like there's some ground ivies that are down here, or some calling Creeping Charlie. I'll see some other ground covers that I recognize. I'm not sure what the plant is, and then I tend to see where it looks like it. Sometimes it holds water. You start looking for those, you see those things, which grow quite common and are easy to stand out, and partially sunny, of course. Then all of a sudden, you'll start looking around, and you'll find the wood sorrel. And, you know, wood sorrel is a good plant. It is high in vitamin C, and it's a tasty addition to your salad. All right, thanks for the views, and thanks for the support. You guys have a good day, and I'll be back later. All right, here's a beautiful specimen of St. John's wort. I know I said I wasn't going to talk about the medicinal uses of plants, but it's mainly because most of what is claimed has not been proven to be scientific fact. With St. John's wort, that's not the case. It is, it has been tested quite a bit and been proven to be helpful with depression. Matter of fact, in Germany, it is used quite common to treat depression, whereas not so much here in the U.S. We do have it as a vitamin supplement, but it is a beautiful plant. But it's easy to recognize. I mean, you know, you see the bright yellow flowers, five petals each. But look at all the stamens on there. I mean, there's just massive amount of them. All right. The other way you can tell that you really have St. John's wort for sure is to take... Let me find a good sized leaf here. Take a leaf. This is not it. here. And I take a leaf, and I don't know if you can see it, but there's tiny little holes all in there. It's almost like you can see, like it's translucent almost in little spots. Those are called stomatas. Now, stomata meaning is plural, but it's basically a port in the leaf that allows the transfer of gases and moisture from inside to out. As a leaf starts to wilt, there's a whole bunch more. As a leaf starts to wilt, those stomatas will close up, keeping in the remaining moisture so that the plant doesn't completely dry up. And then as they pull up more moisture and swell back up, the stomatas will open back up and allow that transfer of gases back and forth between outside and inside the plant for the production of sugars. Alright, and as I was checking these out, I walked in past the St. John's wort and wasn't sure that I was actually going to do a video on St. John's wort. But when I decided to, I started looking around and looked down in there. That's all wood sorrel. I walked right past all this wood sorrel and never even noticed it. But you can see what I'm talking about in here. If you stand back, you got all this tall grass. It kind of blends in and you don't notice it. But then as you get up on it, now it stands out. Got all the little flowers, got seed pods and leaves. But you see how many of them are right here. All right, I'm going to try to put these two videos together into one video. And thanks for watching. Thanks for your support. But if you see all those yellow flowers out there, that's all St. John's wort, by the way. So there's plenty of it out here. But if people were to come out here on a regular basis and start picking it, they would exhaust it. Because so many people will pick an area dry instead of just picking small amounts and leaving some for the next year's growth. All right. Thanks for watching. Thanks for the views. Thanks for listening to my opinions. You guys have a good one.